A quarter of adults in Britain are so obsessed with cleaning and tidying that they spend 2.5 hours or more every weekday on household chores, with many feeling compelled to abide by strict regimes and rituals.
I don't have any hand towel. I can't bear the thought of someone else wiping their hands.
Touching things that haven't moved, I know it doesn't make sense, but I'm not bothering anybody.
If there was a natural disaster, I think I'd still have time to, like, fluff a cushion.
But for most of us, keeping our homes clean and tidy is not a priority. With 1 in 5 of us refusing to accept guests because our homes are so messy.
I haven't had anyone stay in here for, I think, a couple of years, probably.
And 60% even shutting doors so visitors can't see the clutter.
When I said the bedroom is a cupboard, I meant it.
Can a group of obsessive cleaners transform the habits of a nation?
They're the dead mouse.
Moths have already taken to it.
It just makes me feel a bit...
I think I'll knock with me feet.
Or will changing the lives of those with a very different attitude to cleanliness prove too much for the people whose need for perfection?
Do you mind if I just step out? Just the sheer smell
has become an obsession.
Clive needs to put his hand down his pants, find his balls and make a decision.
Full-time mum of 6, Alison from Morton, Lincolnshire, spends over 30 hours a week keeping her 5-bedroom family home immaculate.
From 9 till 3, I clean. I clean the whole of my house. Everything has to be perfect. I probably clean this window every day. We had to sack the window cleaner. We get with the big smear, so I'd go and clean them after the window cleaner had been, so we sacked him. The plug socket, because I've buffed it that many times, I've took the top layer of enamel off it. This is the ensuite bathroom. Don't use the bath. Refer to it as our big ornament.
45-year-old Alison, who spends over £500 a year on cleaning products, was diagnosed with OCD 7 years ago.
I do get really depressed and I do get really down, and I think that's triggered it. And when you clean, you're actually in control.
Her OCD manifests itself with an obsession for order and fear of germs on surfaces.
Floors drive me crazy. We have a steam cleaner which says on the packet 99% of germs. I saw that and I went, fab.
But striving for a germ-free environment affects the rest of the family.
My cleaning routines make me late. I'm late for everything.
There's fashionably late and there's an embarrassing late. And some people are fashionably late, but we're embarrassingly late.
When she's away on holiday, all she's interested in is how clean the house is. She makes me send photos of it to her.
I don't like cleaning. I don't want to be a cleaner. It's the fear of not cleaning. OCD is the fear of not doing, of not cleaning.
Alison hopes that spending 4 days away from home will help confront her anxieties.
I'm hoping it will help me by helping them. And I'm intrigued to see why they're living in that extreme as well. So hopefully we could work together.
She's travelled nearly 100 miles to Hertfordshire to someone's house whose attitudes to cleanliness are very different to her own.
This is good. Here we go.
This horse could never tell you a lie. I'd rather have this horse than any wife. All the mares I've known have always told little porkies, but this one, she's always there, ready to ride any time you want her.
Bachelor Dusty Rhodes spends 6 hours a day down on the farm looking after his 4 horses.
They say the horses got come first, but obviously the house gets neglected. And there you go, that's life.
Back at his terraced home in Waltham Cross, which hasn't been deep cleaned in 19 years, his Wild West collection has taken over.
Yeah, my living room's a bit of a mess. Where I can't find the whole floor. Can't get over there to dust it. Hope my mother not sees this. She'll kill me, I think. My friends have told me that I should do something about it. I need more help and hopefully turn my life around a little bit.
Over the last 15 years, no woman, other than his mother, has spent much time here.
I don't think I could stand a woman like my mother, who's house proud. I couldn't be around one.
Oh my God, look at the windows. Oh my God, it looks terrible. Oh my God, I can do this, I can do this. Okay. Right, I can do this.
Hi, welcome.
Hello.
My name's Dusty.
Hello, my name's Alison. Thank you.
Come in, please come in. Come in here. This is my living room.
Okay. For me, this is quite suffocating. I'm quite shocked, actually. The rest of the house, is it like this?
Yeah.
Okay, so where are we going now, Dusty?
Yeah, this is the kitchen.
Horse feed in your kitchen?
Yeah.
Haven't got a shed?
Well, with rats, that'll be a major problem.
So, what room are we
this
in now,
this is where we want to turn into a more music room.
Oh, it's you want friendly. This as a music room?
Yeah. I like the way I live. But certain things got to change.
OK. Well, we need to go and make a plan then, Dusty. Come on.
Yep.
Alison is keen to give him a taste of the standards she enforces at home.
My cleaning regime is quite intense. Well, I start upstairs. I'd hoover all the bedrooms. I polish all the work surfaces. But then I would, like in the bedrooms, all the curtains have to be symmetrical. I would clean the toilet, clean the bath, clean all the floors. Then I'd do the living room. I hoover the sofa. I hoover the floor.
Al's approach to house cleaning is very extreme.
I think the way to treat Dusty is like a child. We're going to have a set rules. So I've brought some photos to show you of my house. So that's our dining room.
Mm-hmm.
And that's my kitchen.
There's no personal things here. That's not a showroom.
Of course it's not a showroom. We live there. It's clean. Clean. It's about cleaning.
It's selling furniture. It's like being in a... Sorry.
Go on.
It's like being in a prison cell. No, and this is like modern-day living.
Yeah.
I want to die tomorrow.
Don't think he's living in the real world. I think we're two extremes to meet in the middle. We need a plan, don't we?
Yeah.
I think the first thing we need to do is find out what we're going to keep, what we're going to throw. Yeah. We'll start from scratch.
Mm.
I'll show you how I do it, and then you will do it. And if it's not up to my standard, you'll do it again.
One in ten of us clean our bathrooms just once a month. But for some, dirt and disorder in any part of the house is intolerable.
The grass grows over the edge and it makes it messy. So I just neaten it up around the edges.
36-year-old housewife Helen spends 5 hours a day keeping her 4,000 square foot, four bedroom mansion in East Sussex pristine.
We have certain sort of expectations, I suppose. We always say don't judge a book by its cover, but I think if we're all quite honest, we actually do. It's that feeling that you want to fit in, you want to be liked, so I think to a certain extent you try to conform with what's around you. I probably wash the surfaces down probably about 10, 15 times a day. In my head, I get quite out of control, and physically, I suppose, I get quite agitated and quite twitchy, and I can't really sit still.
She often spends 15 hours a week finessing her two-acre garden, and her family's only too aware where housework comes on Helen's priority list.
Sometimes it can get a little frustrating. In particular, you know, around mealtime, sometimes, you know, if we're trying to eat together, Helen will often want to clear up before we actually eat the food. So, you know, often Helen will join a meal halfway through.
Helen's obsessive organising also spreads to her designer wardrobe. Each of the 600 items are catalogued in a phone app so she can choose her daily outfit in advance.
It might be quite fun, actually, if I was going for lunch with the girls to wear the blue skirt, then on top of that, the chunky little blue knit. You know, if I turn up to school in my tracksuit bottoms, I did have a friend once say to me, oh, my God, are you ill?
Take a photo.
For me, helping a hoarder would give me a real sense of achievement, and going into a room that was complete and utter chaos and then actually transforming it, I would get a great sense of satisfaction from seeing them feel better for it.
Helen's taking 4 days out of her stringent routine to help someone whose approach to life is very different from her own.
I'm imagining complete and utter chaos, pandemonia, mess. I'm hoping for a person looking at me with eyes of please come and help me, rather than a face of please go away.
Fifty-year-old Janet from Luton's 20-year passion for haberdashery has taken over her whole house.
I very often start projects and not finish them because I lose interest.
I enjoy knitting, sewing, patchwork, cross stitch. I have no idea how many knitting patterns I own, but I think I've been in some knitting shops that have got less.
She owns 1,000 knitting patterns and has accumulated over 500 balls of wool.
This is a little shrug that I've knitted recently. I've just got to finish it off.
I have actually finished this sock, but I haven't got around to knitting the other one. Sometimes it feels like I'm knitting a cocoon of wool to protect me from all the mess.
Janet's also a keen collector of clothes. The bedroom floor and double wardrobes are home to 800 pieces.
It seems easier to put them on the floor than actually struggle to fit them in the wardrobe.
I'd like my house to be a home where people can come in and feel comfortable, not have to step over things to get to places.
Helen has just 4 days to declutter and organise Janet's 20 years worth of crafts projects.
Good morning.
Hello.
I'm Helen.
I'm Janet.
Hello, Janet. Pleased to meet you.
Thank you.
Yeah, come in.
Come on then, show me upstairs.
Right.
Am I going to need to prepare myself for this?
You are, probably. Right, this is my bedroom. And some of my clothes. It's very pink and girly, as you can see.
How on earth? How do you get? Oh my God,
I climb over. I climb over a lot.
I actually,
you're speechless.
My mouth is on the floor. I am genuinely gobsmacked. Even just having that one dress on the floor would send me into a frenzy, let alone like this. No.
Oh, this is my craft room.
There is just so much stuff in here. I would definitely have all the wool in colour shading.
Right, I don't know whether that would be a bit too extreme for me.
So is this a sitting room?
Yes.
You have a lot of stuff.
Yes. This was one of my first cross stitches
was
I completed.
Okay. This is only dull women have immaculate homes. And it's dusty, look at it.
Yes. it's dirty and it needs a good clean.
It's slightly ironic because there is an air freshener next to me and I can see a duster, but yeah, I don't think they get used. I do a lot of housework. I get up about 6:15 in the morning, and before we come downstairs, all the beds are made. And I will, while the kids are having their breakfast, I will be sweeping and hoovering.
So do you sit down and have breakfast with the children, or would you rather
no.
clean?
I am bad, and I tend to be running around doing jobs and barking orders.
I think maybe Helen has got a void in her life that she fills with cleaning.
I have got a hell of a lot of work to do. I am excited to get stuck in, slightly worried about what's underneath all the piles. We need to get rid of some of the stuff.
In Hertfordshire, OCD diagnosed Alison is taking on 3 rooms in confirmed bachelor Dusty's terraced house. The kitchen, living dining room and spare bedroom.
Really excited.
Yesterday was all about nerves and controlling nerves and finding out about Dusty in the house, but now I've got 3 days to get his house done and I will do it.
I think this house is going to be a more complicated house than she thinks. I can't imagine what she's got in mind for me.
With only 3 days left, they need to pull together to clean and clear the Wild West hoard.
Just going to have to be quite ruthless, but without being cruel, because I don't want him to think that I'm throwing his life away.
Where does it come from? It's not mine.
Oh, wait, is it going to the skip?
Well, I don't know who it is.
Well, don't matter, does it then? It's not come back for it. They've not come back for it for 10 years. They're not coming now.
No. It might be. I don't know.
Don't matter. Come on. Let's be a bit ruthless, Dusty. Right. Come on. Let's live life.
Whoa.
I'm joking. Come on. We need to move stuff to get it out, Dusty.
Agreed.
Okay.
But it takes longer than that than what you're doing.
You're keeping the stuff like a museum.
I think I crunched what you're. You're living in a museum.
I don't live in a bloody museum. I live in a
it's
house
all displayed.
That is clean. It's displayed because it's fresh. No, it isn't displayed.
Cowboy Dusty also worked as a Western DJ, though his last gig was 5 years ago.
Oh, my God. We've got half a car in the dining room. Obviously, it's
yeah,
an issue. A car.
The front is on the decks.
OK. Oh, so you had a disco behind it or something?
Yeah. Down the top.
Ready? One, two, three.
You've got a
pot, dear. Ah! Wait, that's my hand. Well done. A new life, Dusty. A new life.
Alison, who cleans her windows daily, has spotted Dusty's windows have recently been egged.
Right, put the ladder in the middle, because we're going to do the middle one first. When was this egg thrown on the window?
They've done it several times, and I've cleaned it. They've done it again. Just give up in the end.
You give up?
It's bullying by young children.
So people think you're different? Do you think you're different?
No. You get bullied by outside world. Actually, you just go inside your shell.
So you can't become like more of a recluse?
Yeah. How do you feel cleaning somebody else's house as well as with your own?
Cleaning your house is different to cleaning my house because I have a fear of not cleaning my house. Cleaning your house is a challenge to get you to think about how you live. Don't you get like a sense of achievement?
Oh yeah, we'll do once it's
Can you like see now like just doing this?
Get stuck in.
That's what cleaning does. It makes you feel you start off with something really
dirty.
Not all
the time, though, the way you're doing it every day.
Yeah, because I'm obsessive, aren't I?
Yeah, that's right.
And I don't want to be, do I?
Yes, right.
Even though Dusty hasn't thoroughly cleaned his windows for 2 years, he wants to be sure they're perfect.
You're smearing now. It's got to be done again.
Oh.
To my standard.
So it's not to your standard.
No, not to paint that work up there. I want to paint all this again.
Okay, so you're telling me that I've been here for one day and your standards have just shot through the roof in 24 hours. Yesterday I came and you're living in that much space.
Alison.
I'm going to take a breath.
Calm down.
If I was married to Alison, I wouldn't be able to relax for a minute, be all uptight.
He hasn't cleaned his windows for years and years, and then I just tried to tell him how to do it, but obviously he knows better, he does better. I'm not doing it as good. So after Dusty's right, this is Dusty's world. Welcome to Dusty's world. It just made me really angry.
One in 50 people in Britain is diagnosed with obsessive compulsive disorder. For some, this can manifest itself in ritualistic behaviour and fear of germs.
I have to clean the door handles anything up to 200 times a day.
Although we all come into contact with millions of harmless bacteria every day, for germaphobes with a fear of contamination, all bacteria are terrifying.
So dirty.
Mum of three, Hayley, was diagnosed with OCD in 2007, and her compulsions currently manifest themselves in ritualistic cleaning.
Throughout my life, I've had different forms of the OCD. So sometimes I might get intrusive thoughts. I fear that if I don't carry out these rituals, that my children will die. So for me, the important thing to confront my fears.
It smells like fishy wee.
The more I do that, it makes me have control over the illness as opposed to it having control over me.
Today, Hayley and her fellow obsessive cleaners have decided to test their own homes to see just how clean they are. OCD diagnosed mother and daughter, Leslie and Tuesday, spend over 80 hours a week keeping their home spotless and very rarely allow anyone in.
Gotta hoover within an inch of my life.
Joining them is obsessive cleaner Zara, who works full-time and still manages to clean 28 hours a week to reach show home standards.
A show towel is like a display towel. It's a towel in your bathroom, but it's not to be used.
First stop is Hayley's three-bedroom terraced house. She spends 5 hours a day keeping it germ-free.
I am slightly nervous about people swabbing my things, just because I don't want them to walk in and be like, oh, this is disgusting.
Hello.
Hello.
Come in. Zara.
Yes.
Can I just get that leaf off your boot? These pesky little things.
Smelling nice.
Yes, it smells lovely. It smells really fruity and fresh.
Yeah.
It's lovelier. I do use a lot of bleach, and then I also steam my sofa.
Hayley steam cleans her sofa 3 times a day.
I feel like with the steam, it's getting rid of any, like, germs.
Does that not ruin the sofa?
It might, but I don't care.
I've never seen someone steam clean a sofa before, ever. It's just taking it to, like, a whole new level.
I've got a steamer. It's, like, 10 times more powerful than that.
Stop slagging off my steam cleaner. It's really good.
Give it a swab. Fine now. Okay, let's do it. Let's do it, Rose.
To test the sofa, they're using a bacterial measuring device and looking for a hygienic level of 500 or under. Some bacteria can thrive for up to 4 weeks on household items like sofas, but a healthy person will rarely get ill from the germs on their furniture.
Really, nothing to worry about. 290.
Oh, I'm really pleased with that.
I would be quite comfortable to sit on a sofa and not feel any anxiousness at all, would you?
No.
Next, the kitchen, the source of some of Hayley's biggest anxieties.
So, yeah, this is my kitchen. I mainly use bleach in here again. The kitchen is particularly important for me because that's obviously where I make the children's food, and so I like to know that everything's been bleached. That is boiling hot water now going on there.
OK, so are you ready for a swab? Mm. Yeah.
Shut up!
Oh my god!
Oh, wow. That was amazing.
I'm so happy. It was like a winning the lottery, bless her.
But despite her surgically clean reading, OCD diagnosed Hayley is still not convinced her house is sanitary.
Yes, I have had some low readings, but at the same time, my head, it isn't clean enough.
I think you've been really brave to let us in and do this, but I'm still not brave enough to do the swabbing in my house yet. I've only just been diagnosed. I'm still taking little steps. I hope to get there where you are.
Oh, I love you.
I know. I'm so proud of you. I wished I could do it. Yeah.
Next, the group are off to test obsessive cleaner Zara's home.
You've got a cat. Cats bury their own poo.
In Luton, it's the first day of the clean, and Helen is determined to tackle 3 rooms in Janet's house.
Well, I'm thinking that we should start in here. I think we can get quite a lot done in here, which hopefully you will like, and that will mean we feel braver to tackle upstairs.
I think that's a very good idea.
Oh, my lordy. Right, I'm going to have to... I'm being attacked by wool. What's this? Scarf?
That needs unravelling because I'm probably never going to finish it.
OK, bin it.
Bin it?
We're going to unravel it and we've already looked. We've
got the needle. It's a little cuff.
Oh, a cuff?
Yes.
Are you going to use it? You haven't got a pair of them, though?
I have, because there's another one in there somewhere.
OK. How are you finding going through all of this?
Quite soul-destroying, actually, because I knew there was a lot of unfinished projects, but I didn't realise how many.
In her own home, Helen hoovers her sofa and underneath it daily, something Janet's not done for over 6 months.
I could write my name in that. We've got knitting needles, we've got toy cars, we've got
Christmas decorations.
Ooh.
Oh, no, I think we've got the mouse.
We had a hamster in here for a while.
I think he's made a little house. I think it's actually wet.
It shouldn't be.
Oh, my goodness me. Get your nose right in it.
Not good.
Right.
I don't think Helen was impressed to find a little hamster bed behind the sofa, but things could have been worse.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
There is poo.
There is actually poo.
So not funny. It's really not funny and it's really not pleasant, but it's somebody's home and I cannot fathom how she can live with that.
More wool. Surprise, surprise.
Back in Hertfordshire with half a skip filled, mum of six, Alison, who cleans for 30 hours a week, and bachelor Dusty are cracking on with clearing Dusty's Wild West hoard.
What does it feel like for you? That, you know, we can actually walk up and down your house.
Well, I can't wait to get it all done.
You can't?
I can't wait.
Yeah, so you're excited about the future now?
Yeah, yeah.
Brilliant.
Yeah, no problem.
Brilliant. Come on then, I love it. Let's get this carpet up. Oh, just do it. Let's get this one up. Get it in the skip. Roll it. Get it.
Right. Things going well. I think it's taking time, but it's progressing.
It's on.
All over. Done. Well done.
Thank you. Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
After 2 days of exposure to Dusty's 30 years of dust and clutter, Alison is already beginning to feel differently about her OCD.
Now, my OCD's kind of gone out the window and it's turning into it's more about Dusty than me.
God, I'm dying. I've gone to hell.
And OCD is always about me. It's about how I feel, what I want, not what my husband wants or my children want. It's about what I want, and I forget about everybody else. So I'm kind of getting that life isn't always about me. It's about other people.
It's fantastic the way she's holding up. It must be very difficult for her. I'm trying to make allowances for her, but she's a pain in the butt. But she's lovely with it.
With the living dining room emptied, Alison can get cleaning. At home, she wipes all her walls down daily.
In there. Right, Dusty, we're going to clean how I clean. So we're going to, from the top to the bottom, perfect. We're going to clean it all, and then we're going to wipe it off with a dry cloth. And then in an hour, when it's dry, we're going to polish it.
Why does all this cleaning, like, come so important to you?
Yeah, well, I think I've always been a bit obsessive and a bit, I like things my way. But on this Tuesday, the 2nd of October...
Mm-hmm. Let's clean the cloth a little bit. What's upsetting you, Alison?
You asked me why I started cleaning, and I started cleaning because my son died, and I wasn't in control. I don't want to be crying. And I wasn't in control of that. And I started cleaning because I was in control of cleaning. And every time I stopped cleaning, I'd think about him dying and being out of control. So I started cleaning to escape from his dying, and I've come here, and it's his anniversary on Tuesday, and it's really raw for me to talk about it.
Yeah.
He was 9 when he died, and it's horrible, and, you know, for me, cleaning is just something that I have to do. I don't want to do it.
Why are you blaming yourself, is it?
Because you do, don't you? And I still struggle with that day, and that day is Tuesday, and I still get really emotional, and I don't want to be really emotional because then I'm not in control. So then what I would do at home, if that thought came into my head, I would clean. And I would clean until it was perfect.
I can imagine what it could be like. It must be terrible, but it's never happened to me.
I know. Let's get cleaning anyway, because this is what I do.
Yeah.
So let's clean. But thank you for listening to me, and thank you for taking the time out.
I'm trying to.
Thank you.
I don't know what to say. She just made me upset as well, and I'd want to cry with her. People would think a man shouldn't be like that, but I do cry.
Today's been really hard, really hard. I don't regret doing this. I've got a good life compared to Justine. I need to kind of keep that in the sight. It's not about how clean something is. It's what you've got and what to appreciate.
Done, Dan.
Nobody in this day and age can live like this, and that's what's going to get me up tomorrow and get me back here and get that sorted.
In Luton, order-obsessed Helen is attacking three rooms in Janet's terraced house. With the living room decluttered, Helen is now focusing on organising upstairs.
Just about got room to get in.
Right.
Where are we going to start in here?
Yes, go on. Seriously, how much stuff? You can't keep all of this.
Right, this I've had for a little while, but I haven't actually worn it.
I thank the Lord, is all I can say. It's like, no, that's indecent.
That is my fairy cardigan.
No, but listen,
no,
sweetie,
that is my favourite.
No. Right,
you're
stop.
Not having this one.
Stop. Right. Okay, right, stop. I'm not going to say how old you are. But you and I are women of a certain age, okay? We don't wear fairy cardigans.
On top of the 10 fairy cardigans, Janet also owns 25 strapless floral dresses.
That I think I've seen 3 times already.
Yes, but I wear that lots.
No.
Yes.
No way. Look, it's there.
No, I know, but
it's
I do.
It's there or it's
I
there.
You can keep one. You don't need two.
No,
I'm keeping all of them. Put those back on.
No, you can't put them on like that.
Right,
you can't get to
I'm
them.
Not one of your children. You've got to realise that.
I know, but honey,
I like my clothes.
At home, Helen catalogues her entire designer wardrobe on a phone app.
And God knows how I'm going to catalogue it. I don't think there's even enough women memory in the computer to do it.
I don't really want you to catalogue it. I'd rather open the doors than go to a phone.
I am never, ever, ever, ever going to be able to conform to Helen's idea of a wardrobe organisation scheme.
Oh, my God.
She's just not coping with the situation as much as she thinks she is. See, now there is dust everywhere. I am sweating. I'm covered in dust and it's just not even funny. I'm getting cross. This is getting ridiculous. I really don't understand how somebody can have that much stuff. And when you ask them why they've got it, it's because, oh, I love it, it's pretty, it's nice. And I'm like, well, why is it in a crumpled heap?
The average person comes into contact with millions of germs every day. For the vast majority of healthy people, this isn't an issue. But for some sufferers of OCD, it can be a challenge.
The germs are there, you know, they're growing and living and breathing in the air that I'm inhaling and going in my body.
Yeah.
With OCD diagnosed Hayley's home tested...
Shut up!
It's now the turn of obsessive cleaner, Zara.
In you come. I haven't got 16 hours a day to clean. I work full time, I'm a single mum. You can just take your shoes off.
I don't want to take my shoes off because you've got a cat. Cats bury their own poo.
So you don't want to take your shoes off?
If you've got some bags, I'll put bags on.
Unlike the others, Zara is not OCD diagnosed. Her obsessions are about order and creating the appearance of a perfect show home.
With the sofa, I don't steam clean, Hayley. I hoover it and I've got, like, level wipes, so I polish it.
Do you think if it did come up with, like, a high reading, it would bother you at all?
No. If yeah. I was like you guys and I thought, if Izzy sits on that and it's dirty, she might die, I'd freak.
Yeah.
But it's my sofa, it's my house. It could come up 9,786,000.
Yeah.
I wouldn't change anything about it. Well, I hope that ain't leaving a mark.
A reading of 500 or under is considered clean enough to eat your dinner off.
Fine. Where is it?
304. That's amazing, seeing as I don't clean it. Yeah. That's cool.
That is only 7 more than what my sofa came up
as. And you steam clean it daily.
And I steam clean it, yeah.
I'll tell you a little bit about my cleaning rituals in my kitchen. I clean my kitchen twice a day. I'll spray that, and then this as well. It smells a bit hospitaly and clinically, and I like that smell. Yeah.
Have you got a preference to which side you do?
No.
Are you sure?
Yeah, whatever you want.
One. That is really good.
With obsessive cleaner Zara's reading nearly matching OCD diagnosed Hayley's zero, it's been a real eye-opener.
That's a really good reading.
And for spend less time on a sink than we do.
I won't lie, I was just over the moon that I'm nearly on a par with Hayley. And I hope that I've given them something to show them that you don't have to spend all day. You can have a life and a clean home.
It's the final day of the clean in Waltham Cross, and one ton of Dusty's detritus has been cleared from the living dining room. With time running out, there's still the upstairs to clean, but first, Alison's facing her biggest challenge.
Today is about the kitchen. It's about cleaning and getting organised, you know, getting on.
Last day with Alison, and I haven't put a straitjacket yet.
The horse feed, We need to get that out. Well, I've got you a couple of metal bins with padlocks on.
Yeah.
The main thing is, can we get them outside? Because that is such a major issue with cleaning down there.
Coming out.
Bloody hell. It's not stuck. It's not coming out.
Well, we've got mice in the kitchen. A bit in all the carry bags. It's just the stench from that corner. So can we throw anything that's out of date? April 2005.
Can't go out of date. Anything's got,
That's 2005.
Can't go out of date.
Well, if it's out of date, we're going to throw it out. That's
best before, you mean?
Best before 2005?
Best before. Not tomorrow date. Best before, it says on it.
Okay, so it was best before 2005, but in 2013 it's what?
It's not best before. Bottle might be making, but the food inside, it's not gone off. It doesn't go off. It's best before. She's getting mixed up, and a lot of people throw away food. There's nothing wrong with it. I don't want your kitchen, my kitchen, like your kitchen, with nothing out.
We're not going to have it.
I haven't got enough room to put everything in. Organisation.
This is about cleaning. This is about giving you quality of life.
I can't talk.
We couldn't move on Wednesday in this house.
I can't talk. Cut them up. Wouldn't it work? Compared to Alison, this horse has never nagged me once. And I felt I've been nagged for the last 4 days. It's been like a marriage from hell. Good girl.
He really is living in cuckoo land. He can go and play with his horses, talk to them, because they're the only people that listen to him, the only things that listen to him, and then I can get on and clean him. Ding! It's absolutely disgusting. It's making me feel sick. Oh.
In Luton, housewife Helen is facing her final task, Janet's craft room, currently filled with 250 hobby books and 1,000 knitting patterns.
OK, so now we've cleared all the clutter, we can start putting the books back on in order and start tidying stuff, OK? I'm going to put the books all in height and section order.
That does strike me as a little bit over the top.
Janet, you're going to come in here and go, oh, I want to read Creating Original Hand Knitting. If you pull that out and you finish with it, you push it back in that spot. If you put that Vogue Knitting and we put that like that, that's going to look messy. But that does that look nice?
Yes.
No, it doesn't.
I don't see why you need to spend so much time doing the cleaning when it sounds like the perfect house anyway. What's missing in your life?
Oh, gosh. That's getting technical, isn't it? Well, I don't know. I think it's quite lots of, you know, you'll know yourself, being at home on your own all day is quite lonely. I'm at home full time. My husband works away a lot.
Yes.
I don't know what I would do with my time, really.
I don't know at the moment why Helen doesn't go and get a job, because she's got lots of talents that would be very useful in the workplace.
It's been nice to have a buddy, you know, for the day and to have conversation.
Oh, that's lovely, Lindsay.
And I like to chat, and if I'm on my own, I've only got the dog to talk to and he doesn't respond. Chemicals in these ones they're a non-toxic surface cleaner and they're plant-based.
Is it more expensive?
A little bit more expensive, but it comes in a pretty bottle.
And it's a pretty car.
It is a pretty car. So, you know.
In Luton, after 50 hours of cleaning and organising, Helen's work is finished. One of the few people Janet's allowed to visit is friend of 5 years, Wendy. Four days ago, Janet's living room was buried under half a skipload of craft materials, including 500 balls of wool and 30 unfinished projects.
Way, look at this! I've never seen it as tidy as this. This is fantastic. You've got space!
I know!
You've got space! Well done, you!
Thank you, darling.
And Helen.
Oh, thank you.
Before, Janet was unable to move in her cluttered crafts room. Now, with a new set of shelves and 25 plastic boxes, Helen has created an ordered environment for Janet to finish her projects in.
Bedroom.
Oh, wow!
Oh, can I move in?
Oh, please!
I just love the way that it's all organised. You can just see everything that you've got.
Do you think this is going to help Janet to finish her craft projects? Yeah. Having this room here?
Yeah, absolutely.
Because there's no excuse now, is it?
No. Really.
And I've thrown some away.
It's been tough. It's been a challenge.
Before, Janet's bedroom floors were piled high with dresses and fairy cardigans. It's now airy and organised.
Wow, that's so much better.
And I've got space.
Doesn't it look nice at all the colours?
Oh, it does. So organised, that's excellent. You'll be able to reach everything there.
Yes, I know what I've got.
There's only so many, like, turquoise tops a girl needs, but...
So, I've got a wonderful tidy house. Hopefully, you are going to be less lonely because you're going to find something else to do, aren't you?
I need to get a job, don't I?
And also, we'll have to get together and do some knitting.
Yeah, well, you did promise that you would show me how to do it, because I don't know how to do it.
I think having an obsessive compulsive cleaner in was hard work. Very much worth it. She sprinkled all her fairy dust all over the house, and it meant that I wasn't anxious.
I think I should utilise my skills a bit more. I think actually I would really love to go out there and do something more than what I do at the moment.
In Hertfordshire, with just a few hours left to clean, Dusty has returned, and Alison is putting the finishing touches to his house. Due to the kitchen taking longer than expected, Alison's been unable to declutter upstairs, but she has managed to fit shelves for the music room. Dusty's long-term friend John has come to see what he and Alison have achieved.
I've known Dusty 30 years or more. Well, I don't know if he's too old to change or not, but I have tried.
Oh, Kev.
Hey, John.
What? Right. Right, Alison?
Yeah, all right, John.
Go on.
Yeah,
nice to meet you.
Thank you.
4 days ago, Dusty's living area was hidden under a blanket of paperwork, books, dust and old Western props. Now there's space to relax with friends and enjoy the Wild West ambience.
Well, what do you think?
Hello, hi. Well, I've never seen it like this, and it's
what do you think, Dusty?
Yeah, it's gone way beyond what I was going to thought it was going to be.
Oh, okay.
Much better. That's better.
The dining area was packed with clothes and memorabilia that hadn't seen the light of day for 20 years. With some new furnishings and saddle mounts, it's the organised and functional tack room Dusty dreamed of.
A really good job.
Lovely. Fantastic. It's been hard for me to, a stranger, never met before, come into my house and arrange my belongings in the order that she thinks it should be. That's been one of the hardest things. That's about to adapt.
That's good.
Before, Dusty used his kitchen for recording music and storing the horse feed. After 7 hours of elbow grease, Alison has now reclaimed the kitchen.
Unbelievable. I thought I'd be next, you know, next doors. when I came here before, you got all speed there.
Yeah.
Despite the transformation, Dusty still wants to keep his horse feed in the kitchen.
It's got to go outside.
I swept that out and I was heaving because of the stench down there.
The food has got to be done out the back.
You'd have mice if you had it at the back.
Yeah, my house, it'd be out the back. It is out the back.
It's sugar beet and everything you eat.
I've just spent all day cleaning this kitchen and you're moaning that I've took your beet out into a bin.
He's made me that angry that I'm fuming, I'm shaking. It's, you know, someone throw all your hard work back in your face.
It's like a wild horse, really. You won't be able to change him, really. He's 60 years old and he's set in his ways. She's a saint.
I hope she does well in her life and hope she does just relax more and get some sort of good hobby that she can put some of her energy into that rather than cleaning the house.
I know that I need grief counselling, that's the main thing that I've learned, and I'm going to take that on board. So when I go home, I won't be so controlling. I'm still going to clean, but I'm not going to clean to the extreme, and I'm not going to be late. We're going to be on time.
If you're interested in taking part in the next series of Obsessive Compulsive Cleaners, go to www.channel4.com/OC Cleaners.
And support information for the issues raised in this programme can be found at channel4.com/support. Have the Yorkshire Terrors become saints? Let's hope so. We go back to school at Christmas, an Educating Yorkshire special, tomorrow night at 9. Next, a back-breaking drama at a divorce party, 24 hours in A&E.
It goes over the edge and it makes it messy, so I just neaten it up around the edges.
36-year-old housewife Helen spends 5 hours a day keeping her 4,000-square-foot, four-bedroom mansion in East Sussex pristine.
We have certain sort of expectations, I suppose. We always say, don't judge a book by its cover, but I think if we're all quite honest, we actually do. It's that feeling that you want to fit in, you want to be liked, so I think to a certain extent you try to conform with what's around you. I probably wash the surfaces down probably about 10, 15 times a day. In my head, I get quite out of control, and physically, I suppose, I get quite agitated and quite twitchy, and I can't really sit still.
She often spends 15 hours a week finessing her two-acre garden, and her family's only too aware where housework comes on Helen's priority list.
Sometimes it can get a little frustrating. In particular, you know, around mealtime, sometimes, you know, if we're trying to eat together, Helen will often want to clear up before we actually eat the food. So, you know, often Helen will join a meal halfway through.
Helen's obsessive organising also spreads to her designer wardrobe. Each of the 600 items are catalogued in a phone app so she can choose her daily outfit in advance.
It might be quite fun, actually, if I was going for lunch with the girls to wear the blue skirt, then on top of that, the chunky little blue knit. You know, if I turn up to school in my tracksuit bottoms, I did have a friend once say to me, oh, my God, are you ill?
Take a photo.
For me, helping a hoarder would give me a real sense of achievement, and going into a room that was complete and utter chaos and then actually transforming it, I would get a great sense of satisfaction from seeing them feel better for it.
Helen's taking 4 days out of her stringent routine to help someone whose approach to life is very different from her own.
I'm imagining complete and utter chaos, pandemonia, mess. I'm hoping for a person looking at me with eyes of please come and help me, rather than a face of please go away.
Fifty-year-old Janet from Luton's 20-year passion for haberdashery has taken over her whole house.
I very often start projects and not finish them because I lose interest.
I enjoy knitting, sewing, patchwork, cross-stitch. I have no idea how many knitting patterns I own.
Relax for a minute, be all uptight.
He hasn't cleaned his windows for years and years, and then I just tried to tell him how to do it, but obviously he knows better, he does better. I'm not doing it as good. So after Dusty's right, this is Dusty's world. Welcome to Dusty's world. It just made me really angry.
One in 50 people in Britain is diagnosed with obsessive compulsive disorder. For some, this can manifest itself in ritualistic behaviour and fear of germs.
I have to clean the door handles anything up to 200 times a day.
Although we all come into contact with millions of harmless bacteria every day, for germophobes with a fear of contamination, all bacteria are terrifying.
So dirty.
Mum of three, Hayley, was diagnosed with OCD in 2007, and her compulsions currently manifest themselves in ritualistic cleaning.
Throughout my life, I've had different forms of the OCD. So sometimes I might get intrusive thoughts. I fear that if I don't carry out these rituals, that my children will die. So for me, the important thing to confront my fears.
It smells like fishy wee.
The more I do that, it makes me have control over the illness as opposed to it having control over me.
Today, Hayley and her fellow obsessive cleaners have decided to test their own homes to see just how clean they are. OCD diagnosed mother and daughter Leslie and Tuesday spend over 80 hours a week keeping their home spotless and very rarely allow anyone in.
Got a Hoover within an inch of my life.
Joining them is obsessive cleaner Zara, who works full-time and still manages to clean 28 hours a week to reach show home standards.
A show towel is like a display towel. It's a towel in your bathroom, but it's not to be used.
First stop is Hayley's three-bedroom terraced house. She spends 5 hours a day keeping it germ-free.
I am slightly nervous about people swabbing my things, just because I don't want them to walk in and be like, oh, this is disgusting. Hello.
Hello.
Come in. Zara?
Yes?
Can I just get that leaf off your boot? These pesky little things.
Smelling nice.
Yes, it smells lovely. It smells really fruity and fresh.
Yeah,
it's lovelier. I do use a lot of bleach, and then I also steam my sofa.
Hayley steam cleans her sofa 3 times a day.
I feel like with the steam, it's getting rid of any like germs.
Does that not ruin the sofa?
It might, but I don't care.
I've never seen someone steam clean a sofa before ever. It's taking it to like a whole new level.
I've got a steamer. It's like 10 times more powerful than that.
Stop slagging off my stink.
But a healthy person will rarely get ill from the germs on their furniture.
Really, nothing to worry about. 290.
Oh, yay. Yay.
I'm really pleased with that.
I would be quite comfortable to sit on her sofa and not feel any anxiousness at all, would you?
No.
Next, the kitchen, the source of some of Hayley's biggest anxieties.
So, yeah, this is my kitchen. I mainly use bleach in here again. The kitchen is particularly important for me because that's obviously where I make the children's food, and so I like to know that everything's been bleached. That is boiling hot water now going on there.
OK, so are you ready for a swab? Mm. Yeah.
Shut up!
Oh,
oh my god! Oh, wow. That was amazing.
I was so happy. It was like a winning the lottery, bless her.
But despite her surgically clean reading, OCD diagnosed Hayley is still not convinced her house is sanitary.
Yes, I have had some low readings, but at the same time, my head, it isn't clean enough.
I think you've been really brave to let us in and do this, but I'm still not brave enough
to do the swabbing in my house yet. I've only just been diagnosed. I'm still taking little steps. I hope to get there where you are.
Oh, I love you.
I know. I'm so proud of you. I wished I could do it. Yeah.
Next, the group are off to test obsessive cleaner Zara's home.
You've got a cat. Cats bury their own poo.
In Luton, it's the first day of the clean, and Helen is determined to tackle three rooms in Janet's house.
Well, I'm thinking that we should start in here. I think we can get quite a lot done in here, which hopefully you will like, and that will mean we feel braver to tackle upstairs.
I think that's a very good idea.
Oh, my lordy. Right, I'm going to have to... I'm being attacked by wool. What's this? Scarf?
That's needs unravelling because I'm probably never going to finish it.
OK, bin it.
Bin it?
Well, if you're going to unravel it, and we've already looked, we've got...
I need the needle. It's a little cuff.
Oh, a cuff?
Yes.
Are you going to use it? You haven't got a pair of them, though.
I have, because there's another one in there somewhere.
OK. How are you finding going through all of this?
Quite soul-destroying, actually, because I knew there was a lot of unfinished projects, but... I didn't realise how many.
In her own home, Helen hoovers her sofa and underneath it daily.
Yeah, I don't think they get used. I do a lot of housework. I get up about 6:15 in the morning, and before we come downstairs, all the beds are made. And I will, while the kids are having their breakfast, I will be sweeping and hoovering.
So do you sit down and have breakfast with the children, or would you rather clean?
I am bad, and I tend to be... running around doing jobs and barking orders.
I think maybe Helen has got a void in her life that she fills with cleaning.
I have got a hell of a lot of work to do. I am excited to get stuck in, slightly worried about what's underneath all the piles. We need to get rid of some of the stuff.
In Hertfordshire, OCD-diagnosed Alison is taking on three rooms in confirmed bachelor Dusty's terraced house. The kitchen, living dining room and spare bedroom.
Really excited. Yesterday was all about nerves and controlling nerves and finding out about Dusty in the house. But now I've got 3 days to get his house done and I will do it.
I think this house is going to be a more complicated house than she thinks. I can't imagine what she's got in mind for me.
With only 3 days left, they need to pull together to clean and clear the Wild West hoard.
Just going to have to be quite ruthless, but without being cruel, because I don't want him to think that I'm throwing his life away.
Oh, where's it come from? It's not mine.
Oh, wait, is it going to the skip?
Well, I don't know who it is.
Well, it don't matter, does it, then? It's not come back for it. They've not come back for it for 10 years. They're not coming now.
No, it might be... I don't know.
It don't matter. Come on. Let's be a bit ruthless, Dusty. Right. Come on, let's live life.
Whoa.
Come on. We need to move stuff to get it out, Dusty.
Agreed.
Okay. But
it takes longer than that, than what you're doing.
You're keeping the stuff like a museum.
I think I'm crunched what you're... You're living in a museum.
I don't live in a bloody museum. I live in a house that's
clean. It's displayed because it's fresh.
No, it isn't displayed.
Cowboy Dusty also worked as a Western DJ, though his last gig was 5 years ago.
Oh, my God. We've got half a car in the dining room. Obviously, it's
yeah,
an Isuzu car.
The front is on the decks.
OK. Oh, so you had a disco behind it or something?
Yeah. Have you done the top?
Ready? 1, 2, 3.
You've got a box here.
Ah! Wait, that's my hand. Well done. A new life, Dusty. A new life.
Alison, who cleans her windows daily, has spotted Dusty's windows have recently been egged.
Right, put the ladder in the middle, because we're going to do the middle one first. When was this egg thrown on the window?
They've done it several times, and I've cleaned it. They've done it again. I just give up in the end.
You give up?
It's bullying by young children.
This is about cleaning. This is about giving you quality of life.
I can't talk.
We couldn't move on Wednesday in this house.
I can't talk. Cut them up. Wouldn't it work? Compared to Alison, this horse has never nagged me once.
And I felt a bit nagged for the last 4 days. It's been like a marriage from hell. Good girl.
He really is living in cuckoo land. He can go and play with his horses, talk to them, because they're the only people that listen to him, the only things that listen to him, and then I can get on and clean him. Ding! It's absolutely disgusting. It's making me feel sick. Oh.
In Luton, housewife Helen is facing her final task, Janet's craft room, currently filled with 250 hobby books and 1,000 knitting patterns.
OK, so now we've cleared all the clutter, we can start putting the books back on in order and start tidying stuff, OK? I'm going to put the books all in height and section order.
That does strike me as a little bit over the top.
Janet, you're going to come in here and go, oh, I want to read Creating Original Hand Knitting. If you pull that out and you finish with it, you push it back in that spot. If you put that Vogue Knitting and we put that like that, that's going to look messy. But that, does that look nice?
Yes.
No, it doesn't.
I don't see why you need to spend so much time doing the cleaning when it sounds like the perfect house anyway. What's missing in your life?
Oh, gosh. That's getting technical, isn't it? Well, I don't know. I think it's quite lots of, you know, you'll know yourself, being at home on your own all day is quite lonely. I'm at home full time. My husband works away a lot.
Yes.
I don't know what I would do with my time, really.
I don't know at the moment why Helen doesn't go and get a job, because she's got lots of talents that would be very useful in the workplace.
It's been nice to have a buddy, you know, for the day and to have conversation.
Oh, that's lovely, Lindsay.
And I like to chat, and if I'm on my own, I've only got the dog to talk to and he doesn't respond. Chemicals in these ones are they're a non-toxic surface cleaner and they're plant-based.
Is it more expensive?
A little bit more expensive, but it comes in a pretty bottle.
And it's pretty cool.
It is pretty cool. So, you know.
In Luton, after 50 hours of cleaning and organising, Helen's work is finished.
What? We've got the mouse.
We had a hamster in here for a while.
I think he's made a little house. I think it's actually wet.
It shouldn't be.
Oh, my goodness me. Get your nose right in it.
Not good.
Right.
I don't think Helen was impressed to find a little hamster bed behind the sofa, but things could have been worse.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
There is poo. There is actually poo. So not funny. It's really not funny and it's really not pleasant, but it's somebody's home and I cannot fathom how she can live with that.
More wool. Surprise, surprise.
Back in Hertfordshire with half a skip filled, mum of six, Alison, who cleans for 30 hours a week, and bachelor Dusty are cracking on with clearing Dusty's Wild West hoard.
What does it feel like for you? That, you know, we can actually walk up and down your house.
Well, I can't wait to get it all done.
You can't?
I can't wait.
Yeah, so you're excited about the future now?
Yeah, really. Brilliant. Yeah, no problem.
Brilliant. Come on then, I love it. Let's get this carpet up. We'll just do it. Let's get this one up. Get it in the skip. Roll it. Get it.
Right. Things going well. I think it's taking time, but it's progressing.
It's on.
All over. Done. Well done.
Thank you. Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
After 2 days of exposure to Dusty's 30 years of dust and clutter, Alison is already beginning to feel differently about her OCD.
Now, my OCD's kind of gone out the window and it's turning into it's more about Dusty than me. God, I'm dying. I've gone to hell.
That's it.
And OCD is always about me. It's about how I feel, what I want, not what my husband wants or my children want. It's about what I want, and I forget about everybody else. So I'm kind of getting that life isn't always about me. It's about other people.
It's fantastic the way she's holding up. It must be very difficult for her. I'm trying to make allowances for her, but she's a pain in the butt. But she's lovely with it.
With the living dining room emptied, Alison can get cleaning. At home, she wipes all her walls down daily.
In there. Right, just stay. We're going to clean how I clean. So we're going to, from the top to the bottom, perfect. We're going to clean it all, and then we're going to wipe it off with a dry cloth. And then in an hour, when it's dry, we're going to polish it.
Why does all this cleaning like come so important to you?
Yeah, well, I think I've always been a bit obsessive and a bit, I like things
more. After his four horses.
Let's say the horses got come first, but obviously the house gets neglected. And there you go, that's life.
Back at his terraced home in Waltham Cross, which hasn't been deep cleaned in 19 years, his Wild West collection has taken over.
Yeah, my living room's a bit of a mess. Where I can't find the whole floor. Can't get over there to dust it. Hope my mother not sees this. She'll kill me, I think. My friends have told me that I should do something about it. I need more help and hopefully turn my life around a little bit.
Over the last 15 years, no woman, other than his mother, has spent much time here.
I don't think I could stand a woman like my mother who's house proud. I couldn't be around one.
Oh my God, look at the windows. Oh my God, it looks terrible. Oh my God, I can do this, I can do this. Right, I can do this.
Hi, welcome.
Hello.
My name's Dusty.
Hello, my name's Alison.
Alison.
Thank you.
Come in.
Thank
Please you. Come in. Come in here. This is my living room.
Okay. For me, this is quite suffocating. I'm quite shocked, actually. The rest of the house, is it like this?
Yeah.
Okay, so where are we going now, Dusty?
Yeah, this is the kitchen.
Horse feed in your kitchen?
Yeah.
Haven't got a shed?
Well, with rats, that'll be a major problem.
So, what room are we in now?
This is where we want to turn into a more music room.
Oh, you want friendly. This as a music room?
Yeah. I like the way I live, but certain things got to change.
OK. Well, we need to go and make a plan then, Dusty. Come on.
Yep.
Alison is keen to give him a taste of the standards she enforces at home.
My cleaning regime is quite intense. Well, I start upstairs, I'd hoover all the bedrooms, I polish all the work surfaces, but then I would, like in the bedrooms, all the curtains have to be symmetrical. I would clean the toilet, clean the baths, clean all the floors. Then I do the living room, I hoover the sofa, I hoover the floor.
Alison's approach to house cleaning is very extreme.
I think the way to treat Dusty is like a child. We're going to have a set rules. So I've brought some photos to show you of my house. So that's our dining room.
Mm-hmm.
And that's my kitchen.
There's no personal things here. That's our showroom.
Of course it's not a showroom.
Everything's been bleached. That is boiling hot water now going on there.
OK, so are you ready for a swab?
Mm.
Yeah. What? Shut up!
Oh,
yeah.
Oh my God!
Oh, wow. That was amazing.
I'm so happy. It was like a winning the lottery, bless her.
But despite her surgically clean reading, OCD-diagnosed Hayley is still not convinced her house is sanitary.
Yes, I have had some low readings, but at the same time, my head, it isn't clean enough.
I think you've been really brave to let us in and do this, but I'm still not brave enough to do the swabbing in my house yet. I've only just been diagnosed. I'm still taking little steps. I hope to get there where you are.
Oh, I love you.
I know. I'm so proud of you. I wished I could do it. Yeah.
Next, the group are off to test obsessive cleaner Zara's home.
You've got a cat. Cats bury their own poo.
Hello.
In Luton, it's the first day of the clean, and Helen is determined to tackle three rooms in Janet's house.
Well, I'm thinking that we should start in here. I think we can get quite a lot done in here, which hopefully you will like, and that will mean we feel braver to tackle upstairs.
I think that's a very good idea.
Oh, my lordy. Right, I'm going to have to... I'm being attacked by wool. What's this? Scarf?
That's needs unravelling because I'm probably never going to finish it.
OK, bin it.
Bin it?
Well, if you're going to unravel it, and we've already looked...
I need the needle. It's a little cuff.
Oh, a cuff?
Yes.
Are you going to use it? You haven't got a pair of them, though?
I have, because there's another one in there somewhere.
OK. How are you finding going through all of this?
Quite soul-destroying, actually, because I knew there was a lot of unfinished projects, but I didn't realise how many.
In her own home, Helen hoovers her sofa and underneath it daily, something Janet's not done for over 6 months.
I could write my name in that. We've got knitting needles, we've got toy cars, we've got Christmas decorations.
Ooh!
Oh, no, I think we've got the mouse.
We had a hamster in here for a while.
I think he's made a little house. I think it's actually wet.
It shouldn't be.
Oh, my goodness me. Get your nose right in it.
Not good.
I've never seen it like this, and it's
what do you think, Disto?
Yeah.
It's gone way beyond what I was gonna thought it was gonna be.
Oh, okay.
Much better. Much better.
The dining area was packed with clothes and memorabilia that hadn't seen the light of day for 20 years. With some new furnishings and saddle mounts, it's the organised and functional tack room Dusty dreamed of.
Done a really good job.
Lovely. Fantastic. It's been hard for me to... A stranger, never met before.
Yeah.
Come into my house
and
arrange my belongings in the order that she thinks it should be. That's been one of the hardest things. That's about to adapt.
That's good.
Before, Dusty used his kitchen for recording music and storing the horse feed. After 7 hours of elbow grease, Alison has now reclaimed the kitchen.
Unbelievable. I thought I'd be next doors. when I came here before, you've got horse feed there.
Yeah.
Despite the transformation, Dusty still wants to keep his horse feed in the kitchen.
It's got to go outside.
I swept that out and I was heaving because of the stench down there.
The food has got to be done out the back.
You'd have mice if you had it at the back.
Yeah, my house, it'd be out the back. It is out the back.
The sugar beet and everything you eat.
I've just spent all day cleaning this kitchen and you're moaning that I've took your beet out into a bin.
He's made me that angry that I'm fuming, I'm shaking. Someone throw all your hard work back in your face.
It's like a wild horse, really. You won't be able to change him, really. He's 60 years old and he's set in his ways. She's a saint.
I hope she does well in her life and hope she does just relax more and get some sort of good hobby that she can put some of her energy into that rather than cleaning the house.
I know that I need grief counselling, that's the main thing that I've learned, and I'm going to take that on board. So when I go home, I won't be so controlling. I'm still going to clean, but I'm not going to clean to the extreme, and I'm not going to be late. We're going to be on time.
If you're interested in taking part in the next series of Obsessive Compulsive Cleaners, go to www.
That is really good. I knew it was going to be live.
With Obsessive Cleaner Zara's reading nearly matching OCD diagnosed Hayley Zero, it's been a real eye-opener.
That's a really good reading. And for spend less time on a sink than we do. I won't lie, I was just over the moon that I'm
nearly on a par with Hayley, and I hope that I've given them something to show them that you don't have to spend all day, you can have a life and a clean home.
It's the final day of the clean in Waltham Cross, and one ton of Dusty's detritus has been cleared from the living dining room. With time running out, there's still the upstairs to clean, but first, Alison's facing her biggest challenge.
Today is about the kitchen. It's about cleaning and getting organised, you know, getting on.
Last day with Alison, and I haven't put in a straight jacket yet.
The horse feed, We need to get that out. We need to
clean. Are you going to put it afterwards? Back in?
Well, I've got you a couple of metal bins with padlocks on.
Yeah.
The main thing is, can we get them outside? Because that is such a major issue with cleaning down there.
Come on,
Al. Bloody eight. I can't move it. It's not stuck. It's not coming out.
Well, we've got mice in the kitchen. I've eaten all the carry bags. It's just the stench from that corner. So can we throw anything that's out of date? April 2005.
Can't go out of date. Things,
that's, yeah, that can't go out of date. That's 2005.
That can't go out of date.
Well, if it's out of date, we're going to throw it out. That's
best before, you mean?
Best before 2005?
Best before. Best before. Not tomorrow date. Best before, it says on it.
OK, so it was best before 2005, but in 2013 it's what?
It's not best before. Bottle might be making, but the food inside, it's not gone off. It doesn't go off. It's best before. She's getting mixed up, and a lot of people throw away food. There's nothing wrong with it. I don't want your kitchen, my kitchen, not your kitchen, with nothing out.
We're not going to have it. I
haven't got enough room to put everything in. Organisation.
So you're going to move it from one side to the other? Look. That's not clearing the space.
Wait a minute.
This is about cleaning. This is about giving you quality of life.
I can't talk.
We couldn't move on Wednesday in this house.
I can't talk. Cut them up. Wouldn't it work? Compared to Alison, this horse has never nagged me once. And I felt I've been nagged for the last 4 days. It's been like a marriage from hell. Good guess.
Just about got room to get in.
Right.
Where are we going to start in here?
Yes, go on. Seriously, how much stuff?
You can't keep all of this.
Right, this I've had for a little while, but I haven't actually worn it.
I thank the Lord, is all I can say. It's like, no, that's indecent.
That is my fairy cardigan.
No, but listen,
no,
sweetie.
That is my favourite.
No. Right,
you're
stop.
Not having this one.
Stop. Right. Right, stop. I'm not going to say how old you are, but you and I are women of a certain age, okay? We don't wear fairy cardigans.
On top of the 10 fairy cardigans, Janet also owns 25 strapless floral dresses.
That, I think I've seen 3 times already.
Yes, but I wear that once.
No. No way, look, it's there.
No, I know, but
it's there, or it's there.
You can keep one, you don't need two.
No,
I'm keeping all of them. Put those back on.
No, you can't put them on like that.
Right,
you can't get to
them.
I'm
not one of your children. You've got to realise that.
I know, but honey,
I like my clothes.
At home, Helen catalogues her entire designer wardrobe on a phone app.
And God knows how I'm going to catalogue it. I don't think there's even enough blooming memory in the computer to do it.
I don't really want you to catalogue it. I'd rather open the doors than go to a phone.
I am never, ever, ever, ever going to be able to conform to Helen's idea of a wardrobe organisation scheme.
Oh, my God.
She's just not coping with the situation as much as she thinks she is.
See, now there is dust everywhere. I am sweating. I'm covered in dust and it's just not even funny. I'm getting cross. This is getting ridiculous. I really don't understand how somebody can have that much stuff. And when you ask them why they've got it, it's because, oh, I love it. It's pretty. It's nice. And I'm like, well, why is it in a crumpled heap?
The average person comes into contact with millions of germs every day. For the vast majority of healthy people, this isn't an issue, but for some sufferers of OCD, it can be a challenge.
The germs are there, you know, they're growing and living and breathing in the air that I'm inhaling and going in my body.
Yeah.
With OCD diagnosed, Hayley's home tested.
Shut up!
It's now the turn of obsessive cleaner, Zara.
In you come. I haven't got 16 hours a day to clean. I work full time, I'm a single mum. You can just take shoes off.
I don't want to take my shoes off because you've got a cat. Cats bury their own poo.
So you don't take shoes off?
If you've got some bags, I'll put bags on.
Unlike the others, Zara is...
spend so much time doing the cleaning when it sounds like the perfect house anyway. What's missing in your life?
Oh, gosh. That's getting technical, isn't it?
Well, I don't... I think it's quite lots of... You know, you'll know yourself, being at home on your own all day is quite lonely. I'm at home full time. My husband works away a lot.
Yes.
I don't know what I would do with my time, really.
I don't know at the moment why Helen doesn't go and get a job, because she's got lots of talents that would be very useful in the workplace.
It's been nice to have a buddy, you know, for the day and to have conversation.
Oh, that's lovely, Lindsay.
And I like to chat, and if I'm on my own, I've only got the dog to talk to, and he doesn't respond. Chemicals in these ones are they're a non-toxic surface cleaner, and they're plant-based.
Is it more expensive?
A little bit more expensive, but it comes in a pretty bottle.
And it's pretty car.
It is pretty car. So, you know.
In Luton, after 50 hours of cleaning and organising, Helen's work is finished. What?
We've got the mouse.
We had a hamster in here for a while.
I think he's made a little house. I think it's actually wet.
It shouldn't be.
Oh, my goodness me. Get your nose right in it.
Not good. I don't think Helen was impressed to find a little hamster bed behind the sofa, but things could have been worse.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. There is poo. There is actually poo. This is so not funny. It's really not funny, and it's really not pleasant. But it's somebody's home, and I cannot fathom how she can live with that. More wool. Surprise, surprise.
Back in Hertfordshire with half a skip filled, mum of six, Alison, who cleans for 30 hours a week, and bachelor Dusty are cracking on with clearing Dusty's Wild West hoard.
What does it feel like for you? That, you know, we can actually walk up and down your house.
Well, I can't wait to get it all done.
You can't?
I can't wait.
Yeah, so you're excited about the future now?
Yeah, yeah, no problem.
Brilliant. Come on then, I love it. Let's get this carpet. Oh, we'll just do it. Let's get this one up. Get it in the skip. Roll it. Get it.
Cleaning's going well. I think it's taking time, but it's progressing.
It's on.
All over. Done. Well done.
It is pretty cool. So, you know.
In Luton, after 50 hours of cleaning and organising, Helen's work is finished. What?
We've got the mouse.
We had a hamster in here for a while.
I think he's made a little house. I think it's actually wet.
It shouldn't be.
Oh, my goodness me. Get your nose right in it.
Not good.
Right. I don't think Helen was impressed to find a little hamster bed behind the sofa, but things could have been worse.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. There is poo. There is actually poo. This is so not funny. It's really not funny, and it's really not pleasant. But it's somebody's home, and I cannot fathom how she can live with that. More wool. Surprise, surprise.
Back in Hertfordshire with half a skip filled, mum of six, Alison, who cleans for 30 hours a week, and bachelor Dusty are cracking on with clearing Dusty's Wild West hoard.
What does it feel like for you? That, you know, we can actually walk up and down your house.
Well, I can't wait to get it all done.
You can't?
I can't wait.
Yeah, so you're excited about the future now?
Yeah, yeah, no problem.
Brilliant. Come on then, I love it. Let's get this carpet. Oh, we'll just do it. Let's get this one up. Get it in the skip. Roll it. Get it.
Right. Cleaning's going well. I think it's taking time, but it's progressing.
It's on.
All over. Done. Well done.
Thank you.
After 2 days of exposure to Dusty's 30 years of dust and clutter, Alison is already beginning to feel differently about her OCD.
Now, my OCD's kind of gone out the window, and it's turning into it's more about Dusty than me.
God, I'm dying. I've gone to hell. Oh.
And OCD is always about me. It's about how I feel, what I want, not what my husband wants or my children want. It's about what I want, and I forget about everybody else. So I'm kind of getting that life isn't always about me. It's about other people.
It's fantastic the way she's holding up. It must be very difficult for her. I'm trying to make allowances for her, but she's a pain in the butt. But she's lovely with it.
With the living dining room emptied, Alison can get cleaning. At home, she wipes all her walls down daily.
In there. Right, just we're going to clean how I clean. So we're going to, from the top to the bottom, perfect. We're going to clean it all and then we're going to wipe it off with a dry cloth.
I think I've been in some knitting shops that have got less.
She owns 1,000 knitting patterns and has accumulated over 500 balls of wool.
This is a little shrug that I've knitted recently. I've just got to finish it off.
I have actually finished this sock, but I haven't got around to knitting the other one. Sometimes it feels like I'm knitting a cocoon of wool to protect me from all the mess.
Janet's also a keen collector of clothes. The bedroom floor and double wardrobes are home to 800 pieces.
It seems easier to put them on the floor than actually struggle to fit them in the wardrobe.
I'd like my house to be a home where people can come in and feel comfortable, not have to step over things to get to places.
Helen has just 4 days to declutter and organise Janet's 20 years worth of crafts projects.
Good morning.
Hello.
I'm Helen.
I'm Janet.
Hello, Janet. Pleased to meet you.
Thank you. Yeah, come in.
Come on then, show me upstairs.
Right.
Am I going to need to prepare myself for this?
You are, probably. Right, this is my bedroom. And some of my clothes. It's very pink and girly, as you can see.
How on earth? How do you get?
Oh my God, climb over. Janet! I climb over a lot.
I actually,
you're speechless.
My mouth is on the floor. I am genuinely gobsmacked. Even just having that one dress on the floor would send me into a frenzy, let alone like this. No.
Oh, this is my craft room.
There is just so much stuff in here. I would definitely have all the wool in colour shading.
Right, I don't know whether that would be a bit too extreme for me.
So is this the sitting room?
Yes.
You have a lot of stuff.
Yes. This was one of my first cross stitches
was
I completed.
Okay. Only dull women have immaculate homes. And it's dusty, look at it!
Yes.
it's dirty and it needs a good clean. It's slightly ironic because there is an air freshener next to me and I can see a duster, but yeah, I don't think they get used. I do a lot of housework. I get up about 6:15 in the morning and before we come downstairs, all the beds are made and I will, while the kids are having their breakfast, I will be sweeping and hoovering.
So do you sit down and have breakfast with the children or would you rather
no.
clean?
I don't think Helen was impressed to find a little hamster bed behind the sofa. But things could have been worse.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
There is poo.
There is actually poo.
So not funny. it's really not funny and it's really not pleasant, but it's somebody's home and I cannot fathom how she can live with that.
More wool. Surprise, surprise.
Back in Hertfordshire with half a skip filled, mum of six, Alison, who cleans for 30 hours a week, and bachelor Dusty are cracking on with clearing Dusty's Wild West hoard.
What does it feel like for you that, you know, we can actually walk up and down your house?
Well, I can't wait to get it all done.
You can't?
I can't wait.
Yeah, so you're excited about the future
yeah,
now?
Yeah, really. Yeah, no problem.
Brilliant. Come on then, I love it. Let's get this carpet. Oh, we'll just do it. Let's get this one up. Get it in the skip. Roll it. Get it.
Cleaning's going well. I think it's taking time, but it's progressing.
It's on.
All over. Done.
Well done.
Thank you. Oh, my God. Oh my
After
God,
2 days of exposure to Dusty's 30 years of dust and clutter, Alison is already beginning to feel differently about her OCD.
Now, my OCD's kind of gone out the window and it's turning into it's more about Dusty than me.
God, I'm dying. I've gone to hell.
And OCD is always about me. It's about how I feel, about what I want, not what my husband wants or my children want. It's about what I want, and I forget about everybody else. So I'm kind of getting that life isn't always about me. It's about other people.
It's fantastic the way she's holding up. It must be very difficult for her. I'm trying to make allowances for her, but she's a pain in the butt. But she's lovely with it.
With the living dining room emptied, Alison can get cleaning. At home, she wipes all her walls down daily.
In there. Right, just we're going to clean how I clean. So we're going to, from the top to the bottom, perfect. We're going to clean it all, and then we're going to wipe it off with a dry cloth. And then in an hour, when it's dry, we're going to polish it.
Why does all this cleaning like come so important to you?
Yeah, well, I think I've always been a bit obsessive and a bit, I like things my...
After his four horses.
Let's say the horses got come first, but obviously the house gets neglected. And there you go, that's life.
Back at his terraced home in Waltham Cross, which hasn't been deep cleaned in 19 years, his Wild West collection has taken over.
Yeah, my living room's a bit of a mess, where I can't find the whole floor.
I like things my...
After his four horses.
Let's say the horses got come first, but obviously the house gets neglected. And there you go, that's life.
Back at his terraced home in Waltham Cross, which hasn't been deep cleaned in 19 years, his Wild West collection has taken over.
Yeah, my living room's a bit of a mess, where I can't find the whole floor. Can't get over there to dust it. Hope my mother not sees this. She'll kill me, I think. My friends have told me that I should do something about it. I need more help, and hopefully turn my life around a little bit.
Over the last 15 years, no woman, other than his mother, has spent much time here.
I don't think I could stand a woman like my mother, who's house proud. I couldn't be around one.
Oh, my God, look at the windows. Oh, my God, it looks terrible. Oh, my God, I can do this, Okay. Right, I can do this.
Hi, welcome.
Hello.
My name's Dusty.
Hello, my name's Alison.
Hello, Alison.
Thank you.
Come in.
Thank
Please you. Come in. Come in here. This is my living room.
Okay. For me, this is quite suffocating. I'm quite shocked, actually. The rest of the house, is it like this?
Yeah.
Okay, so where are we going now, Dusty?
Yeah, this is the kitchen.
Horse feed in your kitchen?
Yeah.
Haven't got a shed?
Well, with rats, that would be a major problem.
So, what room are we
this
in now,
This is
then?
Where we want to turn into a more music room.
Oh, music you want friendly. This as a music room?
Yeah. I like the way I live. But certain things got to change.
Okay. Well, we need to go and make a plan then, Dusty. Come on.
Yep.
Alison is keen to give him a taste of the standards she enforces at home.
My cleaning regime is quite intense.
Well, I'd start upstairs. I'd hoover all the bedrooms. I'd polish all the work surfaces. But then I would, like in the bedrooms, all the curtains have to be symmetrical. I would clean the toilet, clean the baths, clean all the floors. Then I'd do the living room. I hoover the sofa. I hoover the floor.
House approach to house cleaning is very extreme.
I think the way to treat Dusty is like a child. We're going to have a set rules.
So I've brought some photos to show you of my house. So that's our dining room.
Mm-hmm.
And that's my kitchen.
There's no personal things here. That's like a showroom.
Of course.
You know, often Helen will join a meal halfway through.
Helen's obsessive organising also spreads to her designer wardrobe. Each of the 600 items are catalogued in a phone app so she can choose her daily outfits in advance.
It might be quite fun, actually, if I was going for lunch with the girls to wear the blue skirt, then on top of that, the chunky little blue knit. You know, if I turn up to school in my tracksuit bottoms, I did have a friend once say to me, "Oh, my God, are you ill?"
Take a photo.
For me, helping a hoarder would give me a real sense of achievement, and going into a room that was complete and utter chaos and then actually transforming it, I would get a great sense of satisfaction from seeing them feel better for it.
Helen's taking 4 days out of her stringent routine to help someone whose approach to life is very different from her own.
I'm imagining complete and utter chaos, pandemonium, mess. I'm hoping for a person looking at me with eyes of please come and help me, rather than a face of please go away.
Fifty-year-old Janet from Luton's 20-year passion for haberdashery has taken over her whole house.
I very often start projects and not finish them because I lose interest.
I enjoy knitting, sewing, patchwork, cross-stitch. I have no idea how many knitting patterns I own.
Relax for a minute, be all uptight.
He hasn't cleaned his windows for years and years, and then I just tried to tell him how to do it, but obviously he knows better, he does better. I'm not doing it as good. So I feel Dusty's right. This is Dusty's world. Welcome to Dusty's world. It just made me really angry.
One in 50 people in Britain is diagnosed with obsessive compulsive disorder. For some, this can manifest itself in ritualistic behaviour and fear of germs.
I have to clean the door handles anything up to 200 times a day.
Although we all come into contact with millions of harmless bacteria every day, for germaphobes with a fear of contamination, all bacteria are terrifying. Mum of three, Hayley, was diagnosed with OCD in 2007, and her compulsions currently manifest themselves in ritualistic cleaning.
Throughout my life, I've had different forms of the OCD, so sometimes I might get intrusive thoughts. I fear that if I don't carry out these rituals, that my children will die. So for me, the important thing to confront my fears.
It smells like fishy wee.
The more I do that, it makes me have control over the illness.
And I felt a bit nagged for the last 4 days. It's been like a marriage from hell. Good guess.
Just about got room to get in.
Right.
Where are we going to start in here?
Yes, go on. God, seriously, how much stuff?
You can't keep all of this.
Right, this I've had for a little while, but I haven't actually worn it.
I thank the Lord. Is all I can say. It's like, no, I mean, no, that's indecent.
That is my fairy cardigan.
No, but listen,
no,
sweetie.
No, that is my fairy cardigan.
No.
Right, you're stop. Not having this one.
Stop. Right. Okay, right, stop. I'm not going to say how old you are, but you and I are women of a certain age, okay? We don't wear fairy cardigans.
On top of the 10 fairy cardigans, Janet also owns 25 strapless floral dresses.
That I think I've seen 3 times already.
Yes, but I wear that once.
No.
Yes.
No way, look, it's there.
No, I know, but
it's
I do.
It's there, or it's
I
there.
You can keep one, you don't need two.
No, I'm keeping all of them.
Put those back on.
No, you can't put them on like that. Like, you can't get to
them.
I'm
not one of your children. You've got to realise that.
I know, but honey...
I like my clothes.
At home, Helen catalogues her entire designer wardrobe on a phone app.
And God knows how I'm going to catalogue it. I don't think there's even enough blooming memory in the computer to do it.
I don't really want you to get a catalogue. I'd rather open the doors than go to a phone.
I am never, ever, ever, ever going to be able to conform to Helen's idea of a wardrobe organisation scheme.
Oh, my God.
She's just not coping with the situation as much as she thinks she is.
See, now there is dust everywhere. I am sweating. I'm covered in dust and it's just not even funny. I'm getting cross. This is getting ridiculous. I really don't understand how somebody can have that much stuff. And when you ask them why they've got it, it's because, oh, I love it. It's pretty. It's nice. And I'm like, well, why is it in a crumpled heap?
The average person comes into contact with millions of germs every day. For the vast majority of healthy people, this isn't an issue. But for some sufferers of OCD, it can be a challenge.
The germs are there, you know, they're growing and living and breathing in the air that I'm inhaling and going in my body.
Yeah.
With OCD diagnosed Hayley's home tested...
Shut up!
It's now the turn of obsessive cleaner, Zara.
In your camp, I haven't got 16 hours a day to clean. I work full time, I'm a single mum. You can just take shoes off.
I don't want to take my shoes off because you've got a cat. Cats bury their own poo.
Okay. How are you finding going through all of this?
Quite soul-destroying, actually, because I knew there was a lot of unfinished projects, but I didn't realise how many.
In her own home, Helen hoovers her sofa and underneath it daily, something Janet's not done for over 6 months.
I could write my name in that. We've got knitting needles, we've got toy cars, we've got Christmas decorations.
Ooh!
Oh, no, I think we've got the mouse.
We had a hamster in here for a while.
I think he's made a little house. I think it's actually wet.
It shouldn't be.
Oh, my goodness me. Get your nose right in it.
Not good.
Right.
I don't think Helen was impressed to find a little hamster bed behind the sofa, but... things could have been worse.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
There is poo. There is actually poo. So not funny. It's really not funny and it's really not pleasant, but it's somebody's home and I cannot fathom how she can live with that. More wool. Surprise, surprise.
Back in Hertfordshire with half a skip filled, mum of six, Alison, who cleans for 30 hours a week, and bachelor Dusty are cracking on with clearing Dusty's Wild West hoard.
What does it feel like for you? That, you know, we can actually walk up and down your house?
Well, I can't wait to get it all done.
You can't?
I can't wait.
Yeah, so you're excited about the future now?
Yeah, yeah, no problem.
Brilliant. Come on then, I love it. Let's get this carpet up. Oh, Dusty, let's get this one up. Get it in the skip. Roll it, get it.
Things going well. I think it's taking time, but it's progressing.
It's on.
All over. Done. Well done.
Thank you. Oh my God. Oh my God.
After 2 days of exposure to Dusty's 30 years of dust and clutter, Alison is already beginning to feel differently about her OCD.
Now, my OCD's kind of gone out the window and it's turning into it's more about Dusty than me.
God, I'm dying. I've gone to hell.
And OCD is always about me. It's about how I feel, at what I want, not what my husband wants or my children want. It's about what I want and I forget about everybody else. So I'm kind of getting that life isn't always about me. It's about other people.
It's fantastic the way she's holding up. It must be very difficult for her. I'm trying to make allowances for her. But she's a pain in the butt. But she's lovely with it.
The plug socket, because I've buffed it that many times, I've took the top layer of enamel off it. This is the ensuite bathroom. Don't use the bath. Refer to it as our big ornament.
45-year-old Alison, who spends over £500 a year on cleaning products, was diagnosed with OCD 7 years ago.
I do get really depressed and I do get really down, and I think that's triggered it. And when you clean, you're actually in control.
Her OCD manifests itself with an obsession for order and fear of germs on surfaces.
Floors drive me crazy. We have a steam cleaner which says on the packet 99% of germs. I saw that and I went, fab.
But striving for a germ-free environment affects the rest of the family.
My cleaning routines make me late. I'm late for everything.
There's fashionably late and there's an embarrassing late. And some people are fashionably late, but we're embarrassingly late.
When she's away on holiday, all she's interested in is how clean the house is. She makes me send photos of it to her.
I don't like cleaning. I don't want to be a cleaner. It's the fear of not cleaning. OCD is the fear of not doing, of not cleaning.
Alison hopes that spending 4 days away from home will help confront her anxieties.
I'm hoping it will help me by helping them. And I'm intrigued to see why they're living in that extreme as well. So hopefully we could work together.
She's travelled nearly 100 miles to Hertfordshire to someone's house whose attitudes to cleanliness are very different to her own.
That's it. Come on. Here we go. This horse could never tell you a lie. I'd rather have this horse than any wife. All the mares I've known have always told little porkies, but this one, she's always there, ready to ride any time you want to.
Bachelor Dusty Rhodes spends 6 hours a day down on the farm looking after his four horses.
They say the horses got to come first, but obviously the house gets neglected. And there you go, that's life.
Back at his terraced home in Waltham Cross, which hasn't been deep cleaned in 19 years, his Wild West collection has taken over.
Yeah, my living room's a bit of a mess, where I can't find the whole floor. Can't get over there to dust it. Hope my mother not sees this. She'll kill me, I think. My friends have told me that I should do something about it. I need more help and hopefully turn my life around a little bit.
Over the last 15 years, no woman, other than his mother, has spent much time here.
I don't think I could.
Janet also owns 25 strapless floral dresses.
That, I think I've seen 3 times already.
Yes, but I wear that once.
No. Yes. No way, look, it's there.
No, I know, but
it's
I do.
It's there.
You can keep one, you don't need two. No, I'm keeping all of them.
Put those back on. No, you can't put them on like that. Right, you can't get to
them.
I'm
not one of your children. You've got to realise that.
I know, but honey,
I like my clothes.
At home, Helen catalogues her entire designer wardrobe on a phone app.
And God knows how I'm going to catalogue it. I don't think there's even enough blooming memory in the computer to do it.
I don't really want you to catalogue it. I'd rather open the doors than go to a phone.
I am never, ever, ever, ever going to be able to conform to Helen's idea of a wardrobe organisation scheme. She's just not coping with the situation as much as she thinks she is.
See, now there is dust everywhere. I am sweating, I'm covered in dust, and it's just not even funny. I'm getting cross, this is getting ridiculous. I really don't understand how somebody can have that much stuff. And when you ask them why they've got it, it's because, oh, I love it, it's pretty, it's nice. And I'm like, well, why is it in a crumpled heap?
The average person comes into contact with millions of germs every day. For the vast majority of healthy people, this isn't an issue. But for some sufferers of OCD, it can be a challenge.
The germs are there, you know, they're growing and living and breathing in the air that I'm inhaling and going in my body.
Yeah.
With OCD diagnosed Hayley's home tested...
Shut up!
It's now the turn of obsessive cleaner Zara.
In you come. I haven't got 16 hours a day to clean. I work full-time, I'm a single mum. You can just take shoes off.
I don't want to take my shoes off because you've got a cat. Cats bury their own poo.
So you don't take shoes off?
If you've got some bags, I'll put bags on.
Unlike the others, Zara is not OCD diagnosed. Her obsessions are about order and creating the appearance of a perfect show home.
With the sofa, I don't steam clean, Hayley. I hoover it, and I've got, like, leather wipes, so I polish it.
Do you think if it did come up with, like, a high reading, it would bother you at all? No. Yeah.
If I was like you guys and I thought, if Izzy sits on that and it's dirty, she might die, I'd freak.
Yeah.
But it's my sofa, it's my house. It could come up 9,786,000.
Yeah.
I wouldn't change a thing about it. Well, I hope that ain't leaving a mark.
A reading of 500 or under is considered clean enough to eat your dinner off.
Where is it?
304. That's amazing, seeing as I don't clean it. Yeah. That's cool.
That is only 7 more than what my sofa came up
as. And you still clean it daily.
And I
switches to his house. Due to the kitchen taking longer than expected, Alison's been unable to declutter upstairs, but she has managed to fit shelves for the music room. Dusty's long-term friend John has come to see what he and Alison have achieved.
I've known Dusty 30 years or more. Well, I don't know if he's too old to change or not. I have tried.
Oh, Kev.
Hey, John.
What? Right. Right, Alison?
Yeah, all right, John.
Go on.
Yeah,
nice to meet
you.
4 days ago, Dusty's living area was hidden under a blanket of paperwork, books, dust and old Western props. Now there's space to relax with friends and enjoy the Wild West ambience.
Well, what do you think?
Isn't it, eh? Well, I've never seen it like this, and it's
what do you
else.
Think, Dusty?
Yeah.
It's gone way beyond what I was gonna thought it was gonna be.
Oh, okay.
Much better. Much better.
The dining area was packed with clothes and memorabilia that hadn't seen the light of day for 20 years. With some new furnishings and saddle mounts, it's the organised and functional tack room Dusty dreamed of.
Done a really good job.
Lovely. Fantastic. It's been hard for me to, a stranger, never met before,
yeah.
come into my house
yeah.
and arrange my belongings yeah. in the order that she thinks it should be. That's been one of the hardest things. That's about to adapt.
That's good.
Before, Dusty used his kitchen for recording music and storing the horse feed. After 7 hours of elbow grease, Alison has now reclaimed the kitchen.
Oh, unbelievable. I thought I'd be next doors. when I came here before, you got yeah. horse feed there.
Yeah.
Despite the transformation, Dusty still wants to keep his horse feed in the kitchen.
It's got to go outside.
I swept that out and I was heaving because of yeah. the stench down there.
The food has got to be done out yeah. the back.
You'd have mice if you had it at the back.
Yeah, my house. It'd be out the back. It is out the back.
It's sugar beet and everything you eat.
I've just spent all day cleaning this kitchen and you're moaning that I've took your beet out into a bin. He's made me that angry. That I'm fuming, I'm shaking. Someone throw all your hard work back in your face.
It's like a wild horse, really. You won't be able to change him, really. He's 60 years old, and he's set in his ways.
If you're interested in taking part in the next series of Obsessive Compulsive Cleaners, go to www.channel4.com/OC Cleaners.
And support information for the issues raised in this programme can be found at channel4.com/support. Have the Yorkshire Terrors become saints? Let's hope so. We go back to school at Christmas, an Educating Yorkshire special, tomorrow night at 9. Next, back-breaking drama at a divorce party, 24 hours in A&E.
It goes over the edge and it makes it messy. So I just neaten it up round the
edges.
36-year-old housewife Helen spends 5 hours a day keeping her 4,000-square-foot, four-bedroom mansion in East Sussex pristine.
We have certain sort of expectations, I suppose. We always say don't judge a book by its cover, but I think if we're all quite honest, we actually do. It's that feeling that you want to fit in, you want to be liked, so I think to a certain extent you try to conform with what's around you. I probably wash the surfaces down probably about 10, 15 times a day. In my head, I get quite out of control, and physically, I suppose, I get quite agitated and quite twitchy, and I can't really sit still.
She often spends 15 hours a week finessing her two-acre garden, and her family's only too aware where housework comes on Helen's priority list.
Sometimes it can get a little frustrating. In particular, you know, around mealtime, sometimes, you know, if we're trying to eat together, Helen will often want to clear up before we actually eat the food, so... you know, often Helen will join a meal halfway through.
Helen's obsessive organising also spreads to her designer wardrobe. Each of the 600 items are catalogued in a phone app so she can choose her daily outfits in advance.
It might be quite fun, actually, if I was going for lunch with the girls to wear the blue skirt, then on top of that, the chunky little blue knit. You know, if I turn up to school in my tracksuit bottoms, I did have a friend once say to me, oh, my God, are you ill? Take a photo. For me, helping a hoarder...
Helen was impressed to find a little hamster bed behind the sofa, but things could have been worse.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
There is poo.
There is actually poo.
So not funny. It's really not funny and it's really not pleasant, but it's somebody's home and I cannot fathom how she can live with that. More wool. Surprise, surprise.
Back in Hertfordshire with half a skip filled, mum of six, Alison, who cleans for 30 hours a week, and bachelor Dusty are cracking on with clearing Dusty's Wild West hoard.
What does it feel like for you? That, you know, we can actually walk up and down your house.
Well, I can't wait to get it all done.
You can't?
I can't wait.
Yeah, so you're excited about the future now?
Yeah, yeah.
Brilliant.
Yeah, no problem.
Brilliant. Come on then, I love it. Let's get this carpet. Oh, we'll just do it. Let's get this one up. Get it in the skip. Roll it. Get it.
I think it's going well. I think it's taking time, but it's progressing.
It's on.
All over. Done. Well done.
Thank you. Oh, my God. Oh, my
After
God,
2 days of exposure to Dusty's 30 years of dust and clutter, Alison is already beginning to feel differently about her OCD.
Now, my OCD's kind of gone out the window and it's turning into about... It's more about Dusty than me.
God, I'm dying. I've gone to hell.
That's it. And OCD is always about me. It's about how I feel, about what I want, not what my husband wants or my children want. It's about what I want, and I forget about everybody else. So I'm kind of getting that life isn't always about me. It's about other people.
It's fantastic the way she's holding up. It must be very difficult for her. I'm trying to make allowances for her, but she's a pain in the butt. But she's lovely with it.
With the living dining room emptied, Alison can get cleaning. At home, she wipes all her walls down daily.
In there. Right, Dusty, we're going to clean how I clean. So we're going to, from the top to the bottom, perfect. We're going to clean it all, and then we're going to wipe it off with a dry cloth. And then in an hour, when it's dry, we're going to polish it.
Why does all this cleaning, like, come so important to you?
Yeah, well, I think I've always been a bit obsessive and a bit... I like things...
After his four horses.
Let's say the horses got come first, but obviously the house gets neglected. And there you go, that's life.
Back at his terraced home in Waltham Cross, which hasn't been deep cleaned in 19 years, his Wild West collection has taken over.
Yeah, my living room's a bit of a mess. Where I can't find the whole floor. Can't get over there too. Cut them up. Compared to Alison,
This horse has never nagged me once. And I felt I've been nagged for the last 4 days. It's been like a marriage from hell. Good guess.
Just about got room to get in.
Right.
Where are we going to start in here?
Yes, go on. Seriously, how much stuff? You can't keep all of this.
Right, this I've had for a little while, but I haven't actually worn it.
I thank the Lord, is all I can say. It's like, no, that's indecent.
That is my fairy cardigan.
No, but listen,
no, that is my favourite.
No.
Right, you're stop. Not having this one.
Stop. Right. Okay, right, stop. I'm not going to say how old you are. But you and I are women of a certain age, okay? We don't wear fairy cardigans.
On top of the 10 fairy cardigans, Janet also owns 25 strapless floral dresses.
That I think I've seen 3 times already.
Yes, but I wear that
one. No, way. Look, it's there.
No, I know, but
it's there, or it's there.
You can keep one. You don't need two.
No, I'm keeping all of them.
Put those back on.
No, you can't put them on like that. Right, you can't get to
them.
I'm
not one of your children. You've got to realise that.
I know, but honey,
I like my clothes.
At home, Helen catalogues her entire designer wardrobe on a phone app.
And God knows how I'm going to catalogue it. I don't think there's even enough blooming memory in the computer to do it.
I don't really want you to catalogue it. I'd rather open the doors than go to a phone.
I am never, ever, ever, ever going to be able to conform to Helen's idea of a wardrobe organisation scheme.
Oh, my God.
She's just not coping with the situation as much as she thinks she is.
See, now there is dust everywhere. I am sweating. I'm covered in dust and it's just not even funny. I'm getting cross. This is getting ridiculous. I really don't understand how somebody can have that much stuff. And when you ask them why they've got it, it's because, oh, I love it. It's pretty. It's nice. And I'm like, well, why is it in a crumpled heap?
The average person comes into contact with millions of germs every day. For the vast majority of healthy people, this isn't an issue. But for some sufferers of OCD, it can be a challenge.
Germs are there, you know, they're growing and living and breathing in the air that I'm inhaling and going in my body.
Yeah.
With OCD diagnosed Hayley's home tested...
Shut up!
It's now the turn of obsessive cleaner, Zombie.
You'll kill me, I think. My friends have told me that I should do something about it. I need more help and hopefully turn my life around a little bit.
Over the last 15 years, no woman, other than his mother, has spent much time here.
I don't think I could stand a woman like my mother who's house proud. I couldn't be around one.
Oh my God, look at the windows. Oh my God, it looks terrible. Oh my God, I can do this, Okay. Right, I can do this.
Hi, welcome.
Hello.
My name's Dusty.
Hello, my name's Alison.
Hello, Alison.
Thank you.
Come in, please come in. Come in here. This is my living room.
Okay. For me, this is quite suffocating. I'm quite shocked, actually. The rest of the house, is it like this?
Yeah.
Okay, so where are we going now, Dusty?
Yeah, this is the kitchen.
Horse feed in your kitchen?
Yeah.
Haven't got a shed?
Well, with rats, that would be a major problem.
What room are we
this
in now,
this is
then?
Where one turned into a more music room.
Oh, you want friendly. This as a music room?
Yeah. I like the way I live, but certain things got to change.
OK. Well, we need to go and make a plan then, Dusty. Come on.
Yep.
Alison is keen to give him a taste of the standards she enforces at home.
My cleaning regime is quite intense. Well, I start upstairs. I'd hoover all the bedrooms. I polish all the work surfaces. But then I would, like in the bedrooms, all the curtains have to be symmetrical. I would clean the toilet, clean the bath, clean all the floors. Then I'd do the living room. I hoover the sofa, I hoover the floor.
How's the approach to house cleaning is
very extreme.
I think the way to treat Dusty is like a child. We're going to have a set rules.
So I've brought some photos to show you of my house. So that's our dining room.
Mm-hmm.
And that's my kitchen.
There's no personal things here. That's not a showroom.
Of course it's not a showroom.
Dink's been bleached. That is boiling hot water now going on there.
OK, so are you ready for a swab?
Mm.
Yeah.
Shut up!
Oh, oh my god!
Oh, wow. That's amazing.
I was so happy. It was like winning the lottery, bless her.
But despite her surgically clean reading, OCD died.
Become so important to you?
Yeah, well, I think I've always been a bit obsessive and a bit. I like things my way. Mm-hmm. But on this Tuesday, the 2nd of October.
Mm hmm. Let's clean the cloth a little bit. What's upsetting you, Alison?
You asked me why I started cleaning, and I started cleaning because my son died, and I wasn't in control. I don't want to be crying. And I wasn't in control of that. And I started cleaning because I was in control of cleaning. And every time I stopped cleaning, I'd think about him dying and being out of control. So I started cleaning to escape from his dying, and I've come here, and it's his anniversary on Tuesday, and it's really raw for me to talk about it.
Yeah.
He was 9 when he died, and it's horrible. And, you know, for me, cleaning is just something that I have to do. I don't want to do it.
Why are you blaming yourself, is it?
Because you do, don't you? I still struggle with that day, and that day is Tuesday.
Mm.
And I still get really emotional, and I don't want to be really emotional because then I'm not in control. So then what I would do at home, if that thought came into my head, I would clean. And I would clean until it was perfect.
I can imagine what it could be like. It must be terrible. But it's never happened to me.
I know. Let's get cleaning anyway, because this is what I do.
Yeah.
So let's clean. But thank you for listening to me, and thank you for taking the time out.
I'm trying to.
Thank you.
I don't know what to say. She just made me upset as well, and I'd want to cry with her. People would think a man shouldn't be like that, but I do cry.
Today's been really hard, really hard. I don't regret doing this. I've got a good life compared to Dusty, and I need to kind of keep that in the sight. It's not about something, how clean something is. It's what you've got and what to appreciate.
Done, Dan.
Nobody in this day and age can live like this, and that's what's going to get me up tomorrow and get me back here and get that sorted.
In Luton, order-obsessed Helen is attacking 3 rooms in Janet's terraced house. With the living room decluttered, Helen is now focusing on organising upstairs.
Just about got room to get in.
Right.
Where are we going to start in here?
Yes, go on. Seriously, how much stuff? You can't keep all of this.
Right, this I've had for a little while, but I haven't actually worn it.
I thank the Lord, is all I can say. It's like, no, I mean, no, that's indecent.
That is my...
What?
Yeah.
Shut up!
Oh,
oh my God! Wow, that's amazing.
I was so happy, it was like winning the lottery, bless her.
But despite her surgically clean reading, OCD-diagnosed Hayley is still not convinced her house is sanitary.
Yes, I have had some low readings, but at the same time, my head, it isn't clean enough.
I think you've been really brave to let us in and do this, but I'm still not brave enough to do the swabbing in my house yet. I've only just been diagnosed. I'm still taking little steps. I hope to get there where you are.
Oh, I love you.
I know. I'm so proud of you. I wished I could do it.
Yeah.
Next, the group are off to test obsessive cleaner Zara's home.
You've got a cat. Cats bury their own poo.
In Luton, it's the first day of the clean, and Helen is determined to tackle three rooms in Janet's house.
Well, I'm thinking that we should start in here. I think we can get quite a lot done in here, which hopefully you will like, and that will mean we feel braver to tackle upstairs.
I think that's a very good idea.
Oh, my lordy. Right, I'm going to have to... I'm being attacked by wool. What's this? Scarf?
That needs unravelling because I'm probably never going to finish it.
OK, bin it.
Bin it?
Well, if you're going to unravel it, and we've already looked...
Right,
we've
got the needle. It's a little cuff.
Oh, a cuff?
Yes.
Are you going to use it? You haven't got a pair of them, though.
I have, because there's another one in there somewhere.
OK. How are you finding going through all of this?
Quite soul-destroying, actually, because I knew there was a lot of unfinished projects, but I didn't realise how many.
In her own home, Helen hoovers her sofa and underneath it daily.
Yeah, I don't think they get used. I do a lot of housework. I get up about 6:15 in the morning, and before we come downstairs, all the beds are made. And I will, while the kids are having their breakfast, I will be sweeping and hoovering.
So do you sit down and have breakfast with the children, or would you rather clean?
I am bad, and I tend to be running around doing jobs and barking orders.
I think maybe Helen has got a void in her life that she fills with cleaning.
I have got a hell of a lot of work to do. I am excited to get stuck in, slightly worried about what's underneath all the piles. We need to get rid of some of the stuff.
In Hertfordshire, OCD
unravelling because I'm probably never going to finish it.
OK, bin it.
Bin it?
Well, if you're going to unravel it, and we've already looked, we've got...
I need the needle. It's a little cuff.
Oh, a cuff?
Yes.
Are you going to use it? You haven't got a pair of them, though.
I have, because there's another one in there somewhere.
OK. How are you finding going through all of this?
Quite soul-destroying, actually, because I knew there was a lot of unfinished projects, but I didn't realise how many.
In her own home, Helen hoovers her sofa and underneath it daily.
Yeah, I don't think they get used. I do a lot of housework. I get up about 6:15 in the morning, and before we come downstairs, all the beds are made. And I will, while the kids are having their breakfast, I will be sweeping and hoovering.
So do you sit down and have breakfast with the children, or would you rather clean?
I am bad, and I tend to be running around doing jobs and barking orders.
I think maybe Helen has got a void in her life that she fills with cleaning.
I have got a hell of a lot of work to do. I am excited to get stuck in, slightly worried about what's underneath all the piles. We need to get rid of some of the stuff.
In Hertfordshire, OCD diagnosed Alison is taking on three rooms in confirmed bachelor Dusty's terraced house. The kitchen, living dining room and spare bedroom.
Really excited. Yesterday was all about nerves and controlling nerves and finding out about Dusty in the house. But now I've got 3 days to get his house done and I will do it.
I think this house is going to be a more complicated house than she thinks. I can't imagine what she's got in mind for me.
With only 3 days left, they need to pull together to clean and clear the Wild West hoard.
Just going to have to be quite ruthless, but without being cruel, because I don't want him to think that I'm throwing his life away.
Where does it come from? It's not mine.
Oh, wait, is it going to the skip?
Well, I don't know if it is.
Well, it doesn't matter, does it, then? It's not come back for it. They've not come back for it for 10 years. They're not coming now.
No, it might be... I don't know.
It doesn't matter. Come on. Let's be a bit ruthless, Dusty. Come on, let's live life.
Whoa.
I'm joking. Come on. We need to move stuff to get it out, Dusty.
Agreed.
Okay.
But it takes longer than that, than what you're doing.
You're keeping the stuff like a museum.
I think I'm crunched what you're... You're living in a museum.
I don't live in a bloody museum. I live in a house that's
clean. It's displayed because it's fresh.
No, it isn't displayed.
Cowboy Dusty also worked as a Western DJ, though his last gig was 5 years ago.
Oh, my God. We've got half a car in the dining room. Obviously, it's
yeah,
in a car.
The front is on the decks.
OK. Oh, so you had a disco behind it or something?
Yeah. Have you done the top?
Ready? 1, 2, 3.
You've got a box here.
Ah! Wait, that's my hand.